in the comment section that if I'm audible or not and the slides are visible or not. Okay, I think now I am audible. And the slides are visible now. Okay. So just wait for, I will wait for 1 or 2 minutes. After that I will start, let other people join. Hello. Hello. Is the sound now okay? Hello. Hello. Okay, so I think I should start now. I've got comments that it is audible and the slides are also visible. So now, hello, good evening everyone. This is Nihit Kishore and I am going to take your economy lectures. And let me first introduce myself. My full name is Nihit Kishore and I have done my graduation in economics honors. Okay, so I will be taking your Indian economy over the next 25 to 30 classes, I guess it will take around. I will break up the syllabus and all. And also I have also enrolled in the LLB first year this year only. So now let's start about our discussion that what we are going to discuss today. So in today's agenda, I will be covering the methodology. First I will tell you how I'm going to teach, that how the lecture will go and how the it will be planned and what every lectures will contain and how I'm going to teach the pattern of teaching. And then second I will take the syllabus in detail and I will explain it in very detail, because the UPSC syllabus, the problem is that if you take about the prelim syllabus, I will show you after a few slides about the prelim syllabus. It is very vague, you can say it starts and completes in one line, one sentence only, but it does not give a detailed analysis that actually what we have to study. So I will just in detail I will analyze the syllabus for both prelims and mains. I will have break up in the all the topic wise. I will break it into many topics and subtopics which we will be studying. So I will do that. Then what I have also covered is, that will be very helpful I guess, that I will be covering, I have covered all the previous year questions trained, right, for prelims from 2011, since the CSAT paper was introduced till 2019, that what all topics were asked and how much questions were asked from them. Okay, so I have a breakup of that topic wise trends. Then for example, if external sector is there, then how many questions have been asked in external sector for the last 9 years, 2011 to 2019. Then mains after the syllabus change in 2013, I have covered and I have broke that topics also in topic wise for mains from 2013 to 2018. So we will see that how the trend has been working over the last 10 years. Now, after that, I will be giving you some sources, that what sources we have to refer apart from this lecture. We should be focusing on for the Indian economy part, for prelims, and also GS3 economic development part. So I will give you some sources. Sources are always exhaustive in nature. Matlab, you can add many as sources as possible. Some says read this and that. I will give you some limited source which actually you need to study for economy, because economy is a very vast section, and I guess that this section is the most dynamic of all the sections. If we take into consideration science and technology, so whole GS3 of mains is a very dynamic topic. So for economy, you have to refer some more sources than any other topic, because you have to cover very, very dynamic. Then after that, I will take the doubt session of 10 to 15 minutes, I guess. If you have any questions that you are willing to ask about the syllabus or the approach, how you should study the Indian economy or the previous year question trend, any doubt regarding Indian economy introduction, which I will be covering today. So what all doubts you have, you can ask in the last segment of the paper, of the lecture. And at last, I will be giving you the agenda of next class. So I will start with the methodology of how my classes are going to work. I will be taking the classes in this manner. First, I will take the topic. Then I will give a detailed analysis on the topic. I will explain. There will be subtopics of those topics also. I will give detailed analysis on those topics. Then after that detailed analysis, I will relate that topic with current affairs. For example, if the question is asked, if the topic is RBI, suppose, then I will give you the basic information about RBI. That what is the function of RBI, what are the policy measures RBI takes to control inflation and all those things. After discussing all the basic points of RBI, what I will do, I will go to the current segment, that what all steps have RBI taken in the last 2 years, the newest steps. For example, if you have heard, then you must notice in the newspaper that there is something called PCA, Prompt Corrective Action, which RBI has imposed on several banks who are facing NPA crisis. So what is PCA and how is this framework working? How many banks were there? How they are? What are the criteria to be included in the PCA framework by RBI? So I guess I will be covering all those current affairs aspect of that particular topic. Then after that, the topics, I will be taking the previous year questions based on those topics. For example, if the same RBI, then I will take all those questions from 2011 to 2019, which were being asked in UPSC on RBI. So I will be showing you that how I have taught you that topic and how the questions were being asked. So you will be easily able to relate the topic with the actual demand of the new UPSC examination. So that will be very helpful. And just after that, I will give you some practice questions, objectives also. And if the topic covers mains also, then I will give you subjective practice questions also. If those topics does not include mains, for example, there is a topic called National Income and Accounting, where we will be studying GDP and GNP, GVA. But that topic is almost exclusively for prelims. Mains question has not been asked so far from those topics. So I will not be giving a mains question based on those topics. I will be giving you practice questions on like MCQ questions. So for that topic, only prelims question I will give, or otherwise, for example, agriculture, it is being asked in both prelims and mains. So I will give you both the questions for practice, as well as I will show you all the previous year questions also from prelims and mains. Then we will be having a doubt session at the end of the topic for every lecture. 10 to 15 minutes you can ask your doubts. And after that, last, I will give you the topic which I will be covering in the next class, so that you will be prepared at least before coming to the next class. So this is how I am going to take the lecture. This is will be my methodology. And I also would like to request all of you that please first listen to all what I am saying. I am explaining the syllabus. I will take all the doubts at last. In the last doubt section, I will read all your comments, and then I will take all the doubts and I will deliver it. just listen to the lecture first and just understand the syllabus, because I guess syllabus is the most important part of UPSC preparation. So I will just say that please bear with some time with me and listen to the syllabus. I will explain it. If I first I will show you the official syllabus which is being published by UPSC. तो यूपीएससी में क्या है कि यूपीएससी के जो प्रीलिम्स के सिलेबस हैं, ये अगर आप देखें तो आपको दिखता है कि चार टॉपिक हैं इसमें. फॉर एग्जांपल, सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट, पॉवर्टी, इंक्लूजन, डेमोग्राफिक्स एंड सोशल सेक्टर इनिशिएटिव्स. पांच टॉपिक दिए हैं, बट एट लास्ट दे हैव मेंशन एट सेक्टर. नाउ दिस इज वेरी डेंजरस बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट एक्सप्लेन द टॉपिक व्हाट ऑल टॉपिक्स कम्स अंडर दैट एट सेक्टर. सो व्हाट द यूपीएससी एक्सपर्ट्स एंड एनालिसिस हैव डन that they have studied the previous year questions plus the main syllabus, and they have find a way that what all can be the prelims syllabus. I will be covering the what are the detailed syllabus for prelims which I have made after 2-3 slides. So kyunki prelims mein ye aap jo syllabus abhi dekh rahe hain isme kuch bhi detailed mein nahi diya hua, to ye matlab sirf is syllabus ko agar banda leke baithega to samajh mein nahi aayega ki what you all have to study. इसलिए मैंने इसका एक अलग से डिटेल्ड सिलेबस बनाया है प्रीलिम्स मेंस दोनों के लिए, जो भी आगे मैं आपको बताऊंगा. फिलहाल मैं यूपीएससी का सिलेबस आपको बता रहा हूँ कि ये इसमें सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट के बारे में दिया हुआ है, पॉवर्टी के बारे में, इंक्लूजन, डेमोग्राफिक जिसमें पॉपुलेशन वगैरह आती, सोशल सेक्टर इनिशिएटिव गवर्नमेंट्स की जो भी सोशल सेक्टर इनिशिएटिव्स हैं उसके बारे में, और कुछ इसमें खास है नहीं जो कि मैं आपको डिटेल में बताऊँगा अभी 2-3 स्लाइड्स. On the other hand, the main syllabus of UPSC actually is defined. Actually, it is well defined. You can go with that syllabus only. It has given topics. For example, for mains, the first topic is the Indian economy and issues relating to planning, mobilization of resources, growth, development and employment. Now, this is a topic. For example, planning. We all know about planning, the 5-year plan. Then now it is Niti Aayog. So, what are the problems faced by the government in planning, plus the mobilization of resources to allocate the funds, that how this plan should get that much amount of fund, all those problems. Then growth of economy, what are the current situations, parameters, then development, and what are the status of employment, which is always very a debatable topic, employment and unemployment. The second topic is development, biodiversity, environment topic, which has been mixed, I guess. So don't read the second one. The third one, the government budgeting. It starts from third. So government budgeting will include the public finance. The major topic is the public finance. So in public finance, what we are studying that the taxation system, then the budget, types of budget, what kind of type of budget is practiced in India, then that deficits, fiscal deficit, primary deficit, and all those deficits we will be studying, the deficit financing which is being used by the government. So I will be covering all those. Then inclusive growth and issues arising from it. What is inclusive growth? Because this is the most heated argument which is being currently followed, that what is inclusive growth and how we are going to achieve the goal of inclusive growth altogether, and what are the issues arising from it. Then in the main syllabus, we have a major cropping pattern in various parts of the country, that what are the cropping pattern in the country, we will be studying Rabi, Kharifs and all those things. Then different types of irrigation and irrigation system storage. What are the types of irrigation, tank, canal and drip irrigation, the most famous ones. Then we will be studying the storage pattern of irrigation in different parts of the country. Then transport and marketing of agricultural produce. The transport and marketing of agriculture produce, that means the supply chain management, the things that how the products from farm are being delivered, produced and being delivered to the market, and what are the issues facing, like cold storage problem is very common in India. The tons of food get got wasted, food crops got wasted every year. So what are the issues regarding that? Okay, after that we have e-technology in the aid of farmers. Now government has come up with so many e-technologies for the aid of farmers, like you have heard about electronic national agriculture market, ENAM, that is integrating all the markets, agriculture markets on online single platform. So what are the e-technologies have been added to the farmers, like soil health card? It is one of the best initiative for the farmers, which all actually assesses the soil and then gives them a report that what all crops they can grow on that particular soil and what are the requirements of the fertilizer and all those things. Then we have economics of animal rearing, that is livestock farming, dairy farming we are going to study in detail. Then again in mains we have that food processing and related industries. And what are the scope, because it is a very employment generating industry in the primary sector. And what are the locational factors for that industry's upstream and downstream requirement, that is the accessibility to raw material and the accessibility to markets as well. And the supply chain management, how they are going to connect the markets to the farm field. Then we have issues related to direct and indirect farm subsidies and minimum support prices. Now the farm subsidies which India provides is also a issue in the international arena, that is in WTO. America has always questioned the subsidy issues which India is giving subsidies to the farmers. So that we will discuss what are the issues. Then PDS system, MSP and PDS system we have studied. The MSP prices have been increased for so many crops last year, 1.5 times they have been increased to. Now what are the PDS ka objective kya tha? What are the objective of PDS, public distribution system, how it is functioning, what are the limitations and how it's going to be revamped, because so many states have come up with a different PDS system, more reform, more transparent. So what we'll be looking at, the how it is going, how it should be revamped. Now what are the issue of buffer stocks? I told that cold storage problems is there, the food security issue and the technology missions which are being applied. Then we have land reforms in India. We will look into the land reforms from 1991 till the date, that what all land reforms have been done in India for actually for the effective implementation for the benefits of the farmers. Then the effects of liberalization on the economy, what all effects are post 1991 liberalization, privatization and globalization, what all effects it has on the economy, the changes in industrial policy. We will read all those industrial policies right from 56 till the recent ones. And what have been their effect on the industrial growth? The infrastructure, it is also very kind of, you can say it's also there in economic geography also. So it is covering energy, what are energy resources India have. Then ports, roads, airports and railways, we are going to study in the infrastructure. What are the latest also addition in the, what are the latest projects by the government of India? For example, for airports we have Udaan scheme, for railways we have so many new schemes. For roads, that Bharat Mala project. For ports, we have Sagar Mala. So we will be looking at all those schemes also. And then the investment model. Investment models, that how many, there are many types of investment models, like the PPP model, the BOT models. So all those models we will be discussing. What are the models, how it is being actually the share, what, how the share works, and how it actually takes place, and how it is going to help the development of the country, the different investment models. So this was the UPSC syllabus. Now what I have done, I have divided the syllabus in two modules, module 1 and module 2. But module 1 will continue, where module 1 contains all the topics which are basically main prelims oriented. Though questions can be asked from mains also, but basically prelims oriented. So module 1 will be covering, because it's not that means in means they cannot ask questions from module 1, because in planning, for example, there is planning. So from planning they have asked questions recently in means for the last 3-4 years relating to planning, Niti Aayog and all those things. So it can be asked in means, but they are basically pre-topics, objective kind of thing. So in module 1, the first thing what I will be discussing, that will also be our next lecture. The basic concept, we will discuss some basic concept. For example, we will discuss some important terms of economy. Like there are many terms related to economy which we need to understand first, like depreciation. What is depreciation? What is subsidy? What do you mean by fiscal deficit? What is deficit? What is primary deficit? What is devaluation? What is deficit financing? These are some terms with a glossary which one must understood beforehand, before going any of the topics, because you must be aware about the terms. Because sometimes we will study money and backing, there will be a term known as narrow money and broad money. Rather than explaining over there, I will explain what are the narrow money and broad money in the basic concepts only first, so that when I will take that topic separately, it will get revised also, so that you will not feel like an alien type that what this topic is all about, I don't know even what is narrow money and broad money. So I will be covering like that. All that important terms I will define. I will include almost around so many terms are there in the glossary. I will define all of them. Then the second topic of next agenda will be national income and accounting. What I am going to cover in national income and accounting is the accounting methods of income calculation of India or the nation, like GDP, GNP. Now the recent changes post 2015, we have been considering so many things like GVA. Now GDP is also being taken at market price, base year have changed. So we will be taking all those measures, the measurement like GDP, GNP, per capita income, all those things which are being used, and also what are their applications, that where it is used. For example, in IMF, what measurement is used to compare India with other, for in World Bank or in United Nations. So I will be covering all those income and accounting topics. Then I will define, or I will discuss rather, that what is actually the difference between growth and development. Because there is a lot of difference between growth and development. We always hear that India has shown a growth of 11% sometimes around in 2012, 13 or 11, 12. But actually the development is not that high, because development considers so many other aspects and parameters also, while growth is just about the number. That number has increased or decreased. So we will discuss what is the difference between growth and development. Then second topic is planning. Planning in India. In that we will study types of planning. 5-year plans, we will give just a little discussion. We will give only 2 to 3 minutes over 5-year plan, because 5-year plans are no longer valid. They have been scrapped, and they have been the planning commission itself has been replaced by NITI Aayog. So we will not look much into the 5-year plans. Though we will study types of planning, and we will give the major chunk of our time on this topic on NITI Aayog versus Planning Commission, because two or three questions have been asked regarding NITI Aayog versus Planning Commission. So we will give more time to that, and then we will study NITI Aayog 2.0, which has been revamped post the new elections, new NITI Aayog created. And also we will discuss the vision document which has been released by NITI Aayog about the 70 India at 75, that in 2022, how India is going to perform, what all those. So that document I will also discuss. Third topic we have is public finance and fiscal policy. Now public finance and fiscal policy. Public finance contains the budgeting, I already told before. The public finance includes the budgeting part, that what are public finance estimates. What is the income of government, source of income of government, what all are the expenditure of the government, how this expenditure and income is managed, which is actually known as the budgeting of India in India. Then we will discuss the types of budget. Then we will go with the types of deficit. Then we have a different act altogether for budget management, that is FRBM Act, which we will also study, and also the committee which was headed by N.K. Singh to review the working of FRBM Act, we will also look after that. Then we will study the taxation system, which actually took a drastic change 2 years back when GST was introduced. So now we will also look at the new taxation system being applied in India. Then after that, after taxation system, we have a separate, we will give separate time to GST. We will study what is actually all comprises of GST, what all tax were consumed in GST. Then we will study the implications of GST on small and marginal traders, and what are the problems being faced by GST, because their GST rates have been revised so many times in the last 2 years. So we will also study what are the issues being faced by the traders and businessmen in with respect to GST. And we will also study the recent tax reforms, because there has been a bill also regarding direct tax reforms and all those things we will study. So this will be a part for public finance and fiscal policy. Then fourth topic will be monetary policy and banking system. Again, it's a very important topic. with regard to Indian economy and also with mostly with regard to the prelims point of view. In monetary policy and banking system, first we will look after the banking system. That what are the types of banking system? Scheduled commercial banks, regional rural banks, the small finance banks, and all those types of banks we will discuss. Then we will look after the banking reforms taken in India. Like you all know, a huge step taken by Indira Gandhi in 1969, the nationalization of 14 banks. So what all reforms have been taken, and some committees were also being formed, the Maximum Committee 1, Maximum Committee 2, and all those things. We will discuss those committees also, which have been actually formed just because for the reforms of the banking sector. Also, we will study the Basel norms, the Basel 3 norm, which is currently going to be implemented by RBI. So we will study those norms also regarding reforms. Then many other committees, PCNI, Diwan Jalan, we will study all these topics. Then the development banks. I will take this as a separate topic because this is basically for means, mostly for means, the Mudra and SIDBI bank. These two banks have actually been the UPSC, you can say UPSC have given them more light over the last few years, SIDBI and Mudra. They have been asking questions regarding because they are actually focusing more on MSMEs, medium and small, and micro, medium, and small and medium enterprises. So these two development banks will be studying separately. IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016, which was introduced. So, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code will be there. I will teach what all are the provisions of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code and what are the actual procedures, how quickly a firm or something can get insolvent or bankrupt, can be taken out, because there was a problem. The Chakravyuh problem was there. That entry was very easy but exit was very difficult. So this code has been implemented just to solve the exit problem. So we'll discuss this proper topic in detail. Then we have payments bank coming up so fast. So we'll discuss what are the payment bank, what are they can do. So this is a prelims topic. Then I will study and discuss in detail about the RBI. So RBI, what are the functions of RBI, what are the sources of income of RBI, what are the policy measures, where we will come up with the monetary policy, the qualitative and quantitative monetary policy of RBI. We will be discussing that also. Let's CRR, SLR. So all those things we will study. Then monetary policy framework and monetary policy committee, which was actually introduced post 2015, that now a committee decides the benchmark rates like CRR and SLR. Not earlier only it was RBI governor plus two deputy governors. So now it's a committee altogether which decides. So we'll discuss who are the members of committee and what is this monetary policy framework of RBI. Then at last we will discuss the non-banking financial companies. Non-banking financial companies are actually in very recently in news because of those LNFS crisis. So we will discussing NBFC, what is that actually is the criteria of becoming a non-banking financial company, what actually they can offer, can they extend loan or not, can they issue check. So I will be discussing all those things. Then inflation. Inflation is also a very important topic for prelims, mostly for prelims point of view. In inflation, I will be discussing the definition of inflation, what actually is inflation, what are the types of inflation. Because you have heard so many types of inflation, headline inflation, core inflation. I will be discussing that. After the type, we will be studying about the impact of inflation. That what are the impacts of inflation, positive and negative. That sometimes inflation is positive also, because if the economy is going through slowdown, sometimes inflation is required to create demand in the economy. So we will be studying the impacts. Then inflation targeting, how the government and RBI both are targeting inflation, both have their roles altogether in targeting the inflation, to control the inflation. So I will be discussing that. Then measurement of inflation, how inflation is measured in the consumer price index, in the wholesale price index, GDP deflator and all those things. We will be studying about the measurement of inflation. Okay, before starting further, I will just say that I'm discussing the syllabus. So what all I have written over here, I have also attached, you will find the PDF in the link after the video gets over. about the same strategy plan that I what are the highlight of the course that I am going to cover in those days. Every day's agenda is written there that what I am going to cover on that particular day. So I will be covering that part, but if you will wait, and at last I will also show you that PDF which I will be attaching after the link gets over live. So this is just the syllabus I am discussing. I am not discussing the topic. Actually, understanding syllabus is 20% required. 80% is discussing the topics, but understanding syllabus is 20% very much required. So thus I am discussing the syllabus in detail, because for economy you are not going to find a detailed syllabus from UPSC. At least you are not going to find the UPSC website. Only you can figure out looking at the previous year question. I have actually characterized the syllabus and broke it. So I'm just discussing the syllabus, not the topic. All topics will be addressed to accordingly in the coming classes, which I have. I'm going to attach that PDF link of the schedule of the classes, that what I'm going to teach on day 1, day 2 and day 3, like till the last day. So don't worry about that. And I will take all those doubts of yours at last, in the last 10-15 minutes. I will take all those doubts and clear. So next topic is the external sector. It is very also important. When I will show you the question breakup of last year, you will see that external sector has performed very well in the UPSC radar. So external sector comprises of the balance of payments and balance of trade. Balance of payments and balance of trade, you know, BOP crisis we had in 1981, how we get over it. So we have to study what it comprises of balance of payments and balance of trade. Then we have two accounts in external sector, that is current account and capital account. What all comprises of current account, because they ask in prelims, what all will be a part of current account or capital account. So we will be discussing what all are those. Then convertibility, the current account convertibility and capital account convertibility. What is convertibility? Convertibility basically means that how easily a foreign entity or foreign currency gets converted to the local and the vice versa. So what is norms have been eased by the government of India for the current account convertibility and capital account convertibility. So we will be discussing all those things. Then in external sector, the other important topic is the FDI, foreign direct investment. Then FPI, FII. FPI, FII is means the foreign portfolio investment and the foreign institutional investment, which actually invest in the stock market of the other country. So we will be discussing what are the difference between FDI and FPI, which is stable, which is not stable, which is beneficial for the country, more beneficial. Actually, both are beneficial, which is more beneficial. And what are the impacts if they are being withdrawn? Like last year, when currency crisis was going on, there a lot of, and also the American rates were decreased. So many FPIs went back in India from India. Within a short span of around 2-3 months, a lot of money went flow out of India. So what are the all impacts of those FPI and FII? Then we have exchange rate. What are the exchange rates? Floating exchange rate system, then fixed exchange rate system. All those exchange rate systems we will study, and which exchange rate system is being currently followed in India. We will study that also. Then we will study the forex reserves. What all comprises of forex reserves? Who is the guardian of forex reserves and all those things? Then some key terms. I will discuss it before also, but now I will discuss here also the devaluation. Nominal effective exchange rate, real effective exchange rate, all those things that have been asked in exams past year. So we will define some terms related to external sector. Then foreign trade policy of India, the recent one we will study. Then international investment position, that which all countries are actually investing currently in India, the ranking and the sector in which the investment is being taking place. The next topic is industry and public sector undertaking. In industry, we will study the PSU, public sector undertakings, the types reforms post 1991. There are several reforms being taken. Then disinvestment of the PSUs and where the disinvestment proceeds goes, which fund, separate fund has been created also. Then Make in India, we will study separately. Then special economic zones, all those things we will study. The national manufacturing policy of India, we will also study. What are the provisions of it? Then MSMEs. We will give extra focus on Mudra Siddhi. etc. Then a Startup India scheme you will read all together. Startup along with Stand Up India. Then the labor reforms of India. What all are the labor reforms of India? That what all reforms in India we have seen post independence for the labor reforms. So we will be considering all those things in the labor reform. Then IIP, PMI I will discuss, Index of Industrial Production, PMI, IPR issues, Ease of Doing Business Index, all those things are part of industry and PSUs. Then government initiatives, what are all of the government initiatives of India taken for the industry and PSUs. Then financial market for prelims, they have money market, capital market. Nowadays important topic is this blockchain and cryptocurrency. So blockchain and cryptocurrency have been in news. So we will discuss what is actually a blockchain technology and what all are cryptocurrencies. Uske baad, capital market we will also discuss. Then stock exchange. Stock exchanges I will be covering. The Bombay Stock Exchange, the NSE National Stock Exchange, Nifty 50, what is this, N6, what it is. All those things. Then we will study SEBI. What is actually SEBI and what are the other regulators along with SEBI, like IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India, then PFRDI, the Provident Fund Authority. So we will discuss all the other regulators also. Then Financial Stability Development Council. What is FSDC? It has been recently created, which Minister of Finance as a chairperson. We will study what is this council, who are all the members of this council. Then the credit rating agencies like CRISIL, who actually rate agencies, their credit scores, what are all the agencies, and also the international boards which rate the Indian investment positions like Modi and all those things. In the miscellaneous topic part, we will be discussing important international organizations, the WTO issues. Important international organizations will be comprising of the IMF, the World Bank, WTO, all those things. Then WTO issues will study separately, the subsidy issue. Then GSP, Generalized System of Preferences with US, which was ended recently, we will study that. Then the last three topic will be taking in different classes, will be economic survey, the budget, and the census, important facts of the census we will discuss. So these all were the basically mostly for prelims, not solely for prelims, mostly for prelims point of view. Then from module 2, main center. So main centric syllabus, first we will study inclusive growth. What is the definition of inclusive growth? Then types of inclusive growth. What all are the issues faced by government in achieving the target of inclusive growth and sustainable development goals. So all these things will be covered under inclusive growth. After that, poverty and unemployment. Poverty and unemployment. In that we will be taking the definition of both the poverty and unemployment, the different parameters which actually defines what is poverty and what is unemployment, then types of poverty and unemployment, how they are measured in India, because for poverty so we have some measures, but unemployment actually it is very debatable topic. Recently also a survey was taken into account, but it got into very much debate that actually those were actually real numbers or not. So we will study what are the measurements. Then the government initiatives for tackling the poverty and unemployment. What are the various indices and reports like Human Development Index, Multidimensional Poverty Index, and all those reports of both India as well as from international arena. Plus the poverty calculation committees have been created, like Lakrawala Committee, Rangarajan Committee. All those committees will be discussing what all the recommendations they have given regarding the poverty calculation. Then agriculture sector, we will study land reforms. Then subsidy and issues of agricultures. Then green revolution and their issues. And what all other revolutions have been taking place in India, like blue revolution and red revolution, like these things. Then we will give important some of our times to the doubling farmers income, government initiatives jo hai, what actually government is looking when they are saying about doubling the farmers' income, what all should be the provision of it, and also what other government initiatives are also related to doubling farmers' income. Then we will study MSP, APMC Act of different state, and all the model act which has been implemented by center. Other schemes we will discuss, PM Kisan related to agriculture, PM Kisan the recent one, ENAM. Then the agriculture export policy which was announced recently, we will also study that. Then food security, PDS and food processing industries. Issues related to PDS, what all are the issues people are facing, government is facing regarding implementation of PDS. Then PDS reforms have been taking place. Then food processing industries, their supply chain management, all those issues. Government initiative we will study with regard to food security, PDS and food processing. Then infrastructure, types of infrastructure we will study. The energy, roads, railways, ports, shipping and airports, other in detail. Necessary investment, infrastructure investment fund which has been created by government of India, will study, and other funds also. Then government's initiatives, Uran, Sagar, Mala. Investment models, the types, issues and the Kelkar committee which was created, we will study that. And in service sector last, we will study what are the sub-sectors like education, tourism sector, etc. Then performance and issues, what are, how, which sector is performing, how and what are the issues faced by those sectors, and then the government initiatives. So this was a syllabus which I will be covering. I have broke that UPSC syllabus in these two modules, and I will be taking my lecture as per this module only. So first, the next topic we will be taking in the next lecture will be that basic concept only. We will start from this only. Now I will show you actually the PDF, how I am going to take the class, then I will refer to the source. So here you can see the course highlight. Actually it will be around 24 to 26 classes of 1 hour discussion. This will be the classes of core discussion. Separately I will take 5 to 7 classes for current affairs, only for current affairs, plus the doubt sessions I will arrange if required. Now methodology I already told you, so I will not. Now this is a course breakup day wise. First date, that is today, I have taken the introduction, detailed syllabus. After this, I will be covering the previous year question trends, then sources and approach. Some basic concept, this is our day 2, then day 3 planning, day 4, all those topics which I have just discussed, syllabus I have discussed, I have break into these many days. So you will be looking at which day, I will be attaching the link of this PDF after the video stream gets over. You will find in the description. You can see which day I will be teaching what topic. So coming back to the next thing of our agenda of today, that is the previous year question trend topic wise. Now I have done a lot to prepare this actually. So I have put here from 2011 to 2019 the previous year questions trend topic. This is for prelims. Now you can see from what external sector, money and banking and agriculture except 2019, the amount of questions have been asked actually is significant for your UPSC point of view. That external sector, 7 questions in 2019, 3 questions in 2018, 6 questions in 2017, 11 questions in 2016, 6 in 2015. So you can see the breakup that external sector has been in the focus. Then money and banking similarly is on the focus also. Then public finance, agriculture, inflation, you can see we have less questions in prelims. Agriculture is there. So you can see and you can figure it out that which all topics actually are UPSC favorites and which all topics you should be looking forward to. So external sector, money banking, agriculture, I would say. Then government schemes also have been asked recently. So this is the topic, previous year trend topic wise, which I have prepared. You can also go through it. Then the same for me, 2013 to 2018, the marks is there. From, for example, from growth topic to 2018, 15 mark question have been asked. in 2017, 35 marks. So all those topics have been bifurcated as per the marks as in different years, and you can see that growth and almost budget, they have asked questions every year, and then infrastructure investment every year. But you can see from 2015, post 2015, 125 mark questions is being asked out of 250. So this is very significant that Indian economy part from the GS paper 3 out of 250, almost half marks, almost no, it is actually half, is coming only from Indian economy. So that is the thing that you need to understand, that Indian economy is a very significant, plays a significant part. Now after that, I will be discussing what are the sources you should refer. In sources, I will suggest, first you should thoroughly go through the syllabus and previous year questions. You should buy a book or download the previous year questions from UPSC site. And the syllabus, just go through it almost every day. Paste it somewhere, we can see almost every day. Then you have to go to NCERT class 11th and class 12th. In 11th, you have to study the first book, that is Indian Economic Development. And in 12th, you have to study only the introductory macroeconomics, not the micro one. Only the macroeconomics part you have to study. Then newspaper, you have to study the Hindu and Indian Express, both I would suggest. Because for economy, newspaper plays the most vital role. Apart from other subjects, I guess economy is most being covered through newspaper. Thoroughly, and you should give focus on the business page. Then Yojana and Kurukshetra for means, basically you will study, you will refer Yojana and Kurukshetra. Then our lectures will be having the most weighted out of those sources, that will be most important. Then India yearbook, you have to study the states also. They have a separate topic on the states, so you have to study that also. Then economic survey, budget, I will summarize all the provisions of economic survey and budget. So that you have to also cover. Then also the NITI, which has released this vision document that how India is going to look in 2022. You have to study that. Then PIB, I would suggest it's optional. If you have time, you go through PIB and Ministry of Finance website. You can go through there. And it's my huge request, humble request, you can say that please do not refer any standard book for economy. Many will say Ramesh Singh, Uma Kapila, so many books, Dattan Sundaram, Dhingra. But I would suggest, because even if you read any book, I am saying that you cannot ignore all those things which I have mentioned here, except my lecture, yes, you can mention this. But none other than my lectures, nothing you are going to miss even if you study any book. So that would be just a wastage of time, because economy gets updated every day. No book is going to follow that. Book publishes every year, not daily. So these were the sources I would just say. Then, as my methodology, I have told you that I will be giving practice questions for both mains and prelims in every lecture. So if you write any answer, which I will be giving to you in main for mains, or you have any doubt in any questions or some any slide, just send it to me on this email ID or WhatsApp or Telegram me on this number. I will get back to you as soon as possible. So this all I had to took up for today. Now I will be taking the doubts. So please, if you have any doubt, I am looking at all the comments now and I will be seeing. So please ask whatever doubts you have. Okay, NCERT book list update. So I have already told you what all are the books for NCERT. No other book than these two books from NCERT, I would just suggest. Yes, Lakshmi Math, I will be covering the previous year question means also with the topics which I will be teaching. For example, if I will be teaching, suppose the planning, then I will be discussing the questions of previous year question which was asked on planning from mains and prelims both. that the last year they have asked how planning Niti Aayog is better than planning commission, or the comparison between the two. So I will be discussing the question. I will actually explain the topic, then you will all yourself will be able to answer that question, and you can send it to me. Actually, this lecture is actually only, I have actually mentioned, you can see on the YouTube title also, that it was only for introduction class. No topic I will be covering today. So definitely the next topic I will be covering, that I have already told you in the next agenda, it will be there, that this is the agenda of next lecture I will be covering in the next class. Some basic concept, the terms nested income and accounting, and growth versus development. I will be covering this. Okay, what about Ramesh Singh? I have just told you Ramesh Singh, actually any other book, though Ramesh Singh everyone suggests, I would say any other book is published once in a year. Okay, I have Ramesh Singh from of 2015. Now it has been updated 3 times, 3 years. Economy is updated every day. That's why I am not recommending any book, because even after the you study whole book, you have to study all those things which I have said, told you in the sources. You have to go through all these sources even after the book. That's why it will be a hectic. So basically, don't go with just study, make it smart study. So you can ignore the mistake in economy. So do focus on stuff only or previous year also? No, previous years also. Actually, current affairs, I will suggest that you should be taking from 2017 to 19, whole 19, and then 20 up to April. You have to cover this current affairs, because UPSC does not only ask for the last 1 year, they are asking questions for the last 2 to 2.5 years also. So you just not give them any chance. Actually, what you can cover, you should do. Rest is up to them what questions that they are going to ask. So that is why I would say that you should focus not only from 2019, at least from 2017, post 17 examination, 18 and whole 19, then till April 20. Any other questions? Ronak, can we use Ramesh Singh? That's what I said before also. You can use Ramesh Singh. I'm not denying that Ramesh Singh is not a good book. I'm just saying that even after you read Ramesh Singh, because at least completing Ramesh Singh will take, at least Ramesh Singh will be completed in 2 months. You cannot complete it before 2 months if you want to complete thoroughly. Even after that, I would say that you are going to require or need all those things from sources. So that's why I'm saying, make it smart study. You can, if you can ignore the book, you can. What's the problem? A timetable of economic lecture in the week, it will be updated on the website plus the Telegram page as soon as possible. So don't worry about that. The my timetable I have given you, actually, that what all days and on what day I will be teaching. So I will be attaching the link of that document after this session goes gets end. You will get the link. You can check whether that in on what day what topic I am taking. So, and also on request, I will take doubt classes separately. Apart from these 10-15 minutes of doubt classes daily, I will be taking the doubt classes separately also if it is required. Okay, any questions with what syllabus what I have discussed? If you have any questions on syllabus only, or if you want to ask me any question that how I am going to teach, I have explained all those things. If you have any ask question, just ask me. Any syllabus topic which I have missed, or if you think that I have missed something, then you can tell me. Also, any suggestion if you have for me, my voice is audible or not, actually, or not, your suggestion is also welcome. So I don't think that any questions remain there, because everyone, I think your doubts have been cleared, because today only syllabus was being discussed, so there would not be more doubts. But even I can wait for 3-4 more minutes. If you have any doubt, just let me know regarding syllabus, regarding my methodology or anything. Sources also. Microeconomics. Okay, microeconomics you can ignore actually, because this is basically in UPSC the demand is Indian economy. I don't have any problem teaching microeconomics, but that will be important for the economics optional part, not for the GS paper, because I have seen the syllabus. I have actually studied in the honors only, so I know that microeconomics part is basically for the economics optional paper. Those who want to take optional, they should study microeconomics and also many other books. So microeconomics is not necessary for GS paper, so you can ignore that book. Just but macroeconomics you should actually read. You cannot miss that, because micro actually contains some theories and all those things which is actually not relevant, because we have to study the economy of India, and microeconomics basically deals with the on individual level, so you can ignore it. Any other questions? We'll wait 2 more minutes. I hope, Subham, your doubt is clear. Kumar, also, echo is very difficult for me. The whole echo is difficult or not, I don't know, but it is interesting. Actually, it can be difficult for you, but I can make it interesting for you. Because this is the only topic which you will, and also sometimes you can say polity, which you can actually relate while reading the newspaper. Because in echo, what happens is that the syllabus is printed daily in your newspaper. That doesn't matter. I have also not studied in 11-12 the economy. Then I have taken graduation in economics only. I have taken science in my 11-12. But now I have done economics honors. That's not an issue. And for UPSC, so it's never an issue if you are starting with this, because all those topics are going to be very interesting for you. This is mostly the eco part and also the polity part. I also like polity a lot, apart from economy. So don't worry, Rahul, I will make it interesting for you so that it becomes less difficult for you to understand. Aaj ki syllabus, in this today's syllabus, if you have any problem, what I have spoken till now, if you have any problem, just tell me. How can I help you today? From next lecture, I will make it very easy for you, so don't worry. Just try to read the newspaper thoroughly, as good as matlab, newspaper is just, you can see, a Bible for economy. You should study newspaper thoroughly. You will be able to recall and get what actually there is in the newspaper. And if you have any problem in newspaper also, you can just mail me or WhatsApp me what are the problems. 9th, 10th NCERT economy. 9th, 10th NCERT economy is not relevant because it is very basic. They have given some stories about some place, how the people are earning over there. This is not relevant from UPSC point of view. You can study if you want. That's not an issue. But the thing, I am just giving you the sources which will make your preparation crisp and actually relevant for the UPSC point of view. 9th, 10th, you can study economy. But the thing is, I did not find any important link from the 9th, 10th NCERT economics with the UPSC demand. That's why I have not included it over here. Then current affairs part of the ecosystem. Obviously, I have given you the methodology. I'll be teaching the current affairs part with every topic. So this is my methodology. After the topic analysis, I will be detailing, I will be taking the current affairs aspect of that topic, then the previous equation. So current affairs will be discussed almost daily. what all current affairs topics are being there. It will be discussed mostly daily. Then after that, I will take at last the separate 7 to 8 classes of current affairs only, which will be covering all those economy and current, specifically only for current affairs. So at last also I will be taking whatever will be left. Yeah, I will be starting from basic only. That's why the first topic, you can see the basic concepts of economy I will start with. So don't worry, Kumar, you will be getting, you will be start loving economy, I guess. I would try to make it possible. So don't worry about that. Okay, I think I have taken all your doubts and cleared it. So I would like to now end my today's discussion, because it was only for introduction. I have introduced you the syllabus plus the sources, and I have actually explained you what you are going to need to study Indian economy. So thank you everyone. I hope you like the session. Do please, if you have liked it, do please share it with your friends also, so they can also join from the next lecture. Okay, thank you.